that make sense. I know what it looks like, but I choose to go against that. And I'm speaking something different. I'm speaking something different. Claiming something different. Expecting something different. Say,
I cannot explain it. This may not make sense.
I know
what it looks like, but I choose to go
and I'm speaking
that. And I'm speaking something different.
I'm speaking
something different.
I'm claiming
something different.
Find somebody near you.
Expecting something
and tell them
different.
This, listen.
Sister Patricia Massenburg, your narrator and announcer today at the Bible Way Church in Washington, D.C., USA. Bishop Ronald L. Demery Jr. is our pastor, Bishop Smallwood E. Williams, apostle and founder. We are so grateful for this opportunity to come into your homes and offer spiritual reassurance that God is still on the throne during these trying times. It is our hope and prayer that you are inspired through the ministry of song, prayer, and the preached word of God to enable you to face the coming week with confidence. Our scripture of the week is Psalm 98. Our pastor desires that you read this scripture both carefully and prayerfully. That is Psalm 98. If you desire prayer, you can call our special prayer line at 515-604-9997, access code 195-115. There is someone available to pray with you and for you. The number again is 515-604-9997, access code 195-115. If you have sent letters to the church, we will respond as soon as possible. If you are listening to this broadcast, why not telephone a friend and tell them that Bible Way Church is on the air. There is a message of hope for everyone. If you have sent in donations, we thank you so very much. It is my pleasure to turn this portion of the service into the hands of our pastor. He is a mighty man of valor who fervently preaches the indisputable word of God. I present to you our pastor, Bishop Ronald L. Demery, Jr.
Amen. God bless you, everyone. It's good to be in the house of the Lord today. We're so honored and happy to come into your homes and wherever you may be with this message of encouragement. We thank God for you tuning in today. And we get ready to go to our prayer book to page number 35, the prayer for vision, the prayer for vision. Amen. And I ask you to repeat after me. And it reads thusly, I will lift up mine eyes unto the hills. From whence cometh my help?
From whence cometh my help?
To see thy power and thy glory.
To see thy power and thy glory.
It is written,
I have not seen,
nor ear heard,
neither have it entered into the heart of men,
the things which God hath prepared for them that love him.
Thou art my lamp.
O Lord, lighten my darkness.
Open thou mine eyes that I may behold wondrous things out of thy law. O send out thy light and thy truth. Let them lead me in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. The true light, which lighteth every man that cometh into the world. And let everybody say amen. Psalm 29:18 says, where there is no vision, the people perish. Amen. I'm going to ask Sister Tabitha to minister. Amen. In song. Amen. In the name of the Lord, as we get ready to go into prayer.
For you, I am praying. For you, I am praying. For you, I am praying. I'm praying for you. For
critical times. We're praying for you and praying for your family. We're praying for all of those that are across the globe that are dealing with this pandemic. We know that God is greater than anything, and because God is the greatest power, we shall never be defeated. We want you to trust God for your miracle as Pastor T. Vincent Bryan comes and leads us to the throne of grace.
As we pray, great and kind Father, we do bless you. We thank you for yet another brand new day. We woke up with brand new mercies extended unto us, God, and we are grateful. Father, we thank you because you are Lord all by yourself, and there is nobody like you, God. Father, in the name of Jesus, we pray, oh God, that you would look upon the listening audience, that you would touch, heal, deliver, and set free. Father, in the name of Jesus, our world, our country, we're sick, God. Father, we need our land healed, God. Father, you promised in your word that if your people who are called by your name, if we would humble ourselves, God, you promised, oh God, that you would heal our land. Father, we pray in the name of Jesus that you would touch, God, that you would have your way, that you would throw your weight around, God, in the name of Jesus. Father, we pray that you would look upon those that have been affected by this virus, God, in the name of Jesus. Father, we speak healing right now, God, in the name of Jesus. We pray that you would touch their bodies, oh God, that you would rebuke fevers, God, in the name of Jesus, that your name might receive glory and honor, God. Father, we thank you for those that you have protected, oh God, that you put a hedge around us, oh God. You have protected us. You have kept us, God. And we thank you, God, and we give you praise, God, in the name of Jesus. We pray that you would continue to look upon our shepherd, God, in the name of Jesus. Bless him, God. Keep him, God, in the name of Jesus. Bless your people, oh God. Have your way in our lives, God. Father, we promise to give you nothing but glory. We promise to give you nothing but praise, for we are nothing without you. We can't make it without you. Have your way, Father. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Pastor. Amen for that powerful prayer. Amen. In the name of the Lord. Amen. I can feel the power and presence of God. Hallelujah. I can feel the power and presence of God. God said, where two or three are gathered together in my name, there would he be in the midst. And I want you right where you are, whether you're watching by way of Facebook live stream, whether you're listening by way of radio, I want you to just take a moment and put your hands together and thank God that you made it to this day. Hallelujah. Having therefore obtained help from God, we continue to this day. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Amen. Thank you so much, Pastor, for that powerful prayer. I feel God in the room. Glory to God. Amen. And certainly we're praying, amen, for all of you, amen, that are listening, all of those that need healing. Amen. The Bible Way Church family is praying for you. Amen. We do have some people we want to celebrate this week. Amen. On the occasion of their birthday. Amen. Brother James Bryant, Sister Wilda Budd, Sister Virginia Ham, Brother Andre Jackson, Sister Tiffany James, Sister Dolores Kirby, Sister Eula Lewis, Brother Ronald Lipford, Missionary Marjorie Livingston, Lloyd Lumpkin III on his 11th, Elder Timothy Reynolds, Sister Judith Russell, and Sister Ellen Spate. God bless you and happy birthday to you. Amen. And certainly we want to congratulate on this anniversary. Amen. Sister Angel Barr, amen, on the anniversary of her liver and kidney transplant. God bless you, Sister Angel. Amen. We celebrate you in the name of the Lord, and we are so happy for you and praying with you and for you in the name of the Lord. This time, Sister Massenburg is coming, amen, with a ministry, amen, of music.
How many know that the Lord is good? Do you know that the Lord is good? Come on and help me do this song. Lord, you are good and your mercy endureth forever. Lord, you are good and your mercy endureth forever. Come on and help me say, Lord, you are good and your mercy endureth forever. Yeah. Lord, you are good and your mercy endureth forever. People from every nation and tongue, from generation to generation, we worship you. Hallelujah, hallelujah, we worship you for who you are. We worship you. Good and your mercy endureth forever. Lord, you are good and your mercy endureth forever. Lord, you are good, yeah. Lord, you are good and your mercy endureth forever. Lord, you are good and your mercy endureth forever. People from every nation and tongue, from generation to generation, we worship you. Hallelujah, hallelujah, we worship you for who you are, for who you are, for who you are, for who you are.
If you know that he is good all the time, and all the time God is good. Hallelujah. You are good all the time, and all the time you are good. We worship you. We worship you for who you are. You are the King of Kings. You are the Lord of Lords.
and we worship you. We lift you up. We magnify you. We exalt you. You are a mighty God. You are a great God. There are none like you. There's nobody like you. Hallelujah. Come on, somebody put your hands together and praise God. Wherever you are, come on, worship God. Come on, he's worthy of our praise. He's worthy of our worship. Hallelujah. Hey, glory to God. I feel God. I feel God. I feel God in the room. Hallelujah. I'm so glad that God is just not moved by the crowd. He said, where there are two or three gathered together in my name, I will be in the midst of them. And certainly the Spirit of the Lord is in this place. Amen. And we pray, Lord, that you would fill his power and fill his presence that's permeating from this room. The Lord is here. And I want you to know that no matter what our world is facing right now, God is with you. And he's going to give you strength for the journey. And he's going to give you grace for the journey. Be strengthened, my brother. Be strengthened, my sister, in the name of Jesus. Not by might nor by power, but by my spirit, saith the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. We serve a great and mighty God. Hallelujah. And we're excited about what he's doing in this place. Amen. God bless you in the name of the Lord. At this time, Sister Massenburg is coming. Amen. With amen announcements and further instructions. Let's receive her in the name of the Lord.
Thank you, Pastor Demery. March is National Colorectal, Multiple Myeloma, and Kidney Cancer Awareness Month. As our pastor has stated, our scripture of the week is Psalm 98, and the prayer book reading is page 35, The Prayer for Vision. For additional information, please visit our website at www.biblewaywashington.org. Also, be sure to like us on Facebook and follow us on Twitter for a daily inspirational thought from our pastor, Bishop Ronald L. Demery, Jr. And now, our pastor.
Amen. Thank you. Amen. Sister Massenburg. Amen. In the name of the Lord. And we ask you to govern yourselves according to those announcements. Amen. Bible Way family, want you to know that we love you and we're praying for you. And certainly, God is still God. Amen. And he's still on the throne. Amen. And we want to remind you, amen, God has blessed us, amen, with the technology to be able to reach you. Amen. And we want to utilize that during this time where we're not able to physically come together. Amen. Because of the guidelines set forth by local and national governments. Amen. And we want to govern ourselves according to that. But God's word will still go forth. Amen. He said, heaven and earth will pass away, but my word will stand forever. And certainly we want to be able to reach you. And so Sister Massenburg has given you the information. Amen. I want you to know, amen, those of you that are seeking prayer, amen, you can call 515-604-9997. Amen. We have prayer every day. Amen. Three times a day at 6:05 a.m. Also, amen, at 9:05 a.m. and at 12:05 p.m. You can dial that number and use the access code 195115 and join us, amen, in prayer every day. Also, you can join us, amen, via live stream, our mobile app. If you don't have it, you need to download it. Amen. You can go to our website, Facebook, Bible Way YouTube channel, amen, and stay connected with us. And we ask those of you that have not registered, amen, to please register, amen, to receive our updates and text messages by texting BWCDC to 31996. And you'll receive all of our updates and information and reminders, amen, in the name of the Lord. Amen. This Tuesday, we'll be going live again at 6:30 for our Life Class Bible study. So we ask you to join us, amen, on these same mediums in the name of the Lord. Amen. At this time, Sister Tabitha Massenburg is coming with a sermonic solo, and then we're coming back with the word. God bless you.
Can we just worship the Lord? I will lift up
rise to the hills from which cometh my help. My help cometh from the Lord, the Lord which made heaven and earth. He said he would not suffer thy foot to be moved. The Lord that keepeth thee, he will not slumber nor sleep. For the Lord is thy keeper, the Lord is thy shade. Thy foot to be moved. The Lord that keepeth thee, he will not slumber nor sleep. For the Lord is thy keeper, the Lord.
All of my help coming from
Come on, somebody praise him right there. Come on, somebody help me praise him right there. My help cometh from the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. My help, all of my help, cometh from the Lord. Thank you, Sister Massenburg. Amen for that. Amen. Wonderful presentation of music ministry. And certainly we praise God today. Amen for those that are here. Amen. And certainly, amen to these musicians. We praise God for you and thank God for you. Amen. In the name of the Lord. These are very critical times, amen, that we're living in. And we need to pursue God like never before. Amen. This is a time for us to draw nigh to God. And I think God is proving to us that the church is not a building, but the church is the people. Hallelujah. And this morning, I just want to encourage you. I just want to encourage you this morning from the prophecy of Isaiah. That is Isaiah chapter number 54. And I want to commence reading at verse number 11. And I want to conclude at verse number 17. That is the prophecy or the book of Isaiah, chapter number 54, verse 11, down to verse number 17. Amen. And when you have it, indicate the same by saying, I got it. Amen. All right. Come on, let's read together as a family. O thou afflicted, tossed with tempest and not comforted, behold, I will lay thy stones with fair colors and lay thy foundations with sapphires. And I will make thy windows of a gates and thy gates of carbuncles and all thy what? Borders of pleasant stones. And all thy children shall be taught of the Lord, and great shall be the peace of thy children. In righteousness shalt thou be established. Thou shalt be far from oppression, for thou shalt what? Not fear. And from what? For it shall not come near thee. Behold, they shall surely gather together, but not by me. Whatsoever shall gather together against thee shall fall for thy sake. Behold, I have created what? The smith that bloweth the coals in the fire, and that bringeth forth the instrument for his work. And I have what? Created the waster to destroy. Verse 17, no weapon that's formed against thee shall prosper, and every tongue that shall rise against thee in judgment shall be what? This is the heritage of the servants of the Lord, and their righteousness is of me, saith the Lord. I want to talk to you this morning from this subject, no weapon formed. No weapon formed. Hallelujah. No weapon formed. I need you to put that in the atmosphere. No weapon formed. Isaiah is a famous Old Testament prophet who predicted the coming of the Messiah. And I've come by to tell you today, amen, and I know we don't hear this much, but Jesus is coming. And he's coming soon. The signs of the time are here. And we certainly need to govern ourselves accordingly and get prepared for the coming of the Lord. Isaiah received his prophetic calling from God in a stirring vision of God in the temple. Now, how many of you know that God will speak to you in dreams and in visions? Isaiah 6 and 1 says, in the year that King Uzziah died, I saw also the Lord sitting upon the throne, high and lifted up, and his train filled the temple. This vision was the prophet's call to be God's messenger to his people. Isaiah was given a difficult task to inform God's people who believed that they were blessed by God, that the same God was going to destroy them instead because of their disobedience. Understand that Isaiah received this message the year that King Uzziah must die, that King Uzziah died. And there are times in our lives where some things must die in order for us to see the Lord. So this prophet gets this vision and understand some of his background, that he was married to a woman, a man described as the prophetess. In chapter 8, verse 3, they had two sons whom they named Shear Jashub, which means a remnant shall return. And the other was Mayor Shalah Haj Baz, meaning spread the spoil, hasten the booty. That's what it means. These strange names portray the basic themes of the book of Isaiah. God is about to bring judgment upon his people, but after that, there will be an outpouring of God's mercy and grace to the remnant of people that will return to God. And how many of you know, amen, that this is a time for us to return to God? God sent me here this morning to tell you that we got to get back to God. We got to get back to God in our nation. We got to get back to God, amen, in our schools. We got to get back to God in our families. We got to get back to God. And I don't even like to say this, but we need to get back to God in the church. Jesus, help me here. Amen. We need to get back to God. So God told Isaiah that most of his ministry work would be that of judgment. Understand that Isaiah's assignment, amen, was a difficult assignment. He did not have a message of health, wealth, and prosperity. He was not telling everybody, amen, that you're going to have, amen, money tree in your backyard. He was not telling people, amen, amen, that you were going to have everything you need. But he was telling people, amen, that it's time for us to return to God. And how many of you know we need some real prophets and real preachers now that's going to preach the truth of God's word, whether they're being applauded or not? Somebody's got to speak the truth and let people know that Jesus is on his way. If you don't get a car, if you don't get a new house, if you don't get a new suit, understand, if you don't get a check from the government, I want you to understand that Jesus is on his way to return to get his church. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Amen. And so even though he would speak the truth, the people would reject his message. And I've come by to tell, amen, everyone that's involved in ministry, that's doing ministry, you've been called by God. You got to do what God called you to do, whether people like it or they don't like it. You got to do what God has called you to do in spite of the applause of men and in spite of the applause of people. You got to do what God called you to do. Amen. Isaiah 6 and 10 says, make the heart of this people fat and make their ears heavy and shut their eyes, lest they see their eyes and hear with their ears and understand with their heart and convert and be healed. Jesus found these words of Isaiah's call a prediction of the rejection of his message by many of the people. Matthew 13 and 14 says, and in them is fulfilled the prophecy of Isaiah, which saith, by hearing ye shall hear and shall not understand, and seeing ye shall see and shall not perceive. For this people's heart is waxed gross, and their ears are dull of hearing, and their eyes they have closed, lest at any time they should see with their eyes and hear with their ears and should understand with their heart and should be converted, and I should heal them. Isaiah's response to this revelation from the Lord is a lament, amen, in the form of a question, Lord, how long? And I know that Isaiah is not the only one that's asking that question, because if the truth be told, there are many of us that are in the United States and all across the world, we're asking God, how long? How long are we going to have to deal with being quarantined? How long are we going to have to deal, amen, with death? Amen. How long are we going to have to deal with times of uncertainty? How long, amen, are we going to have to deal with the struggle that we're dealing with? dealing with right now, but I hear God speaking this morning saying, not long. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Not long. But I've come by to tell you, it no matter how long we have to go through this, church, I want you to understand that God is not surprised by this pandemic. He knows everything. I serve a God that sits high and looks low, and he knows everything. And I hear God saying, I will give you grace to make it through this. Hallelujah. Glory to God. I'm almost finished. Amen. God answered that Isaiah's ministry would prepare the people for judgment, but one day God promises would be realized. And I want you to understand, amen, that God's promises will be realized. We serve a God that keeps his word, that whatever God has spoken must come to pass. He's saying, yes, you're going to have to go through things. And I want you to understand something, that because we claim the name of Christ, it does not grant us immunity from life's trials and situations. But one thing we have, and the advantage that we have, because understand that when you've got the power of the Holy Spirit, Jesus said, if I go not away, the Comforter will not come. The Comforter, the Paraclete, amen, which means helper. Oh, I've come by to tell you that in your crisis, you've got the helper, because my help cometh from the Lord. Amen. So if you read another translation, it tells us that the Holy Ghost is our advantage. Oh, my God, I've come by to tell you this morning that in spite of the coronavirus, I've got the advantage. They may not have a vaccine. They may not have enough hospital beds, but because I got the power of God resting in my soul, I've got the advantage. I've come by to tell those of you that are listening by way of radio, and those of you that are online, that if you got the power of the Holy Ghost, you got the advantage. And since I got the advantage, I'm going to use it to my advantage, because I got the power. When I wake up in the morning, Lord, they don't have any more hand sanitizers, but will you sterilize my life and keep me clean by the blood? Amen. I know you're at home, and we're going to practice social distancing, but look at somebody and tell them, I got the advantage. Yeah, I got the advantage. Yeah, somebody say, I don't have health care, but you got the advantage. You may not have a job right now, but when God is on your side, you got the advantage, because nay, in all things, we are more than conquerors through Jesus Christ. God that loved us. Hallelujah. Can I give you some promises? God said in Isaiah 41 and 10, fear thou not, for I am with thee. Be not dismayed, for I am thy God. I will strengthen thee. Yea, I will help thee. That sounds like a promise to me. And one thing I know about God, God is a promise keeper. Amen. There'll be times in my family's existence that I will tell my children, we're going to go to the mall on Saturday. And just when it gets time to go, I feel tired in my body and say to them, we'll pick another day. But there are times when they will remind me, but Dad, you promised. And somebody listening to this broadcast today, all you've got to do is remind God that you promised you would keep me in perfect peace if I keep my mind stayed on thee. You promised me that you would never leave me. You'll never forsake me. You said I'll be with you in the sixth trouble, and in the seventh trouble I'll in no wise forsake you. God made a promise. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Isaiah 40, 31 says, but they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. Isaiah 43 and 2 says, when thou passest through the waters, I will be with thee. And though the rivers, they shall not overflow thee. When thou walkest through the fire, thou shalt not be burned, neither shall the flame kindle upon thee. Look at your neighbor and tell him, it ain't gonna work. The fire ain't gonna burn me, and the water is not gonna drown me. It's not gonna work. The news is not only trying to inform us, but they're trying to strike fear. But because I serve a living God, I will not walk in fear and anxiety, but on the truth of the word of God that makes me a promise that he'll be with me in every area of my life because I trust him. Glory to God. I got to get ready to close. I got to get ready to close. Amen. Hallelujah. Pastor, I'm getting ready to give it to you. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Judah now was to experience utter devastation, but to be fulfilled with the destruction of the city by the Babylonians in 587 BC. Oh my God. Can I tell you, Pastor? Amen. That King Nebuchadnezzar would exact harsh and unusual punishment upon the Jews, destroying the temple and the temple furniture. You can destroy the building, but you can't destroy the people. He separates them from the presence of God in their lives. The temple is in ruins, and the temple is in rubble. He separates them from what they know to be the house of God. Oh my God. And takes them into captivity in isolation. I want to talk to somebody here. Amen. Amen. He takes them in isolation, in captivity. Understand, Sister Massenburg, that there were 10,000 that went into captivity. It would be some 49 years later that King Cyrus of Persia makes a decree to release 50,000 Jews to return back to Palestine to begin work on the temple. I'm not that smart, but it seems like to me that more came back than left, because 10,000 left, but 50,000 returned. What am I saying to you? What I'm saying to you, that in this season of coronavirus outbreak, in this time of uncertainty, when you come out of this, you're gonna have more than you did when you came back. Oh, I don't have nobody here that's gonna praise God with me, because wow, you're trying to oppress me. I'm getting better and I'm multiplying every day. And when we come back together, it's gonna be more than what was here before. Can I prophesy that when we come back together, by the way, there's gonna be more of us that come together when we get back than it was when we left. Devil, you thought you were gonna put us out of business, but the devil is a liar, because God is the greatest power. We shall never be defeated. You ain't gonna stop the word. The word shall go forth. The songs of Zion shall go forth. We serve a great God, and now he's given us more ways to be creative, more ways to reach people. I ain't got nobody here. We still got phones, still got the internet. We still gonna preach what thus saith the Lord. I got to get ready to go to my seat. Get ready, Pastor Brian. Hallelujah. I want you to catch this. But although the tree, listen to this, of the house of David would be cut down, Elder Reinhardt, though the tree of the house of David will be cut down, there would still be life in the stump. Oh my God. I want to tell somebody here that the enemy tried to cut your tree down, but there's still life in the stump. God is getting ready to use what I got left over, and what I got left over is going to be the greatest blessing that I have ever seen. Oh, I wish I could talk to somebody here. Isaiah 6:13 says, but yet in shall be a tenth, and it shall return, and shall not be eaten, as a tale tree, and as an oak whose substance is in them when they cast their leaves. So the holy seed shall be the substance thereof. There is life in the stump. It's been cut down, but there's life in the stump. I want y'all to catch this, because out of the lineage of David would come the Messiah, who would establish his eternal rule among his people. I wish I had somebody to say, stop worrying about what you lost, because your greatest blessing is coming out of what you got left. God is getting ready to use what you got left over. They cut the tree down, but the stump had Jesus in it. And the reason why you're able to make it is because Jesus is in your stump. They thought they were going to kill you. They thought it was going to be the end for you. But my life just got started, because Jesus said, I am come that you might have life, and that you might have it more abundantly. They're speaking death in the newspaper, death on Facebook, death on Twitter, but let me speak life to you. Look at somebody in your house and tell them, live. Look at somebody and tell them, live. I hear you, Pastor. Watch me live. Is there anybody here? You made it up in your mind that you're going to live and not die. I shall not die, but live to declare the works of the Lord. Oh my, I got to get ready. I got to get ready to close. I got to get ready to close. Isaiah's message is relatively simple. First, Isaiah addressed God's people's sin, rebelling against the one who made them and redeemed them. Second, Isaiah instructed them to reform their ways and act obediently. Third, Isaiah announced God's judgment on people because of their sin. God revealed his future restoration of his people, or at least of the remnant that survived judgment. As a part of the restoration of God's people, Isaiah saw both judgment on the nations and a future turning of the nations to God. And what I see a great turning towards God. Oh my God. The government doesn't have the answer. I wish I could talk to somebody here. Christ is the answer. And we got to get back to God. We got to get back to holiness. We got to get back to the basics. We got to get back to church. We got to get back to Bible study. We got to get back to Sunday school. We got to get back to worship. Hallelujah. I'm getting ready to close. Notice that after sin, repentance and judgment comes restoration. Oh my God. Oh my God.
God. And the text that we read is in the restoration section. I got a question. What section are you sitting in? I'm in the restoration section. Oh my God. You can be in the chaotic section if you want. You can be in the discouraged section if you want. But I'm in the restoration section. Oh, look at your neighbor and ask him, what section are you in? Amen. What's on your ticket? Oh my God. Amen. I ain't got nobody here. Let me get ready to close. And he starts off by saying, sing, O barren. Oh my God. Thou that didst not bear, break forth into singing and cry aloud, that thou didst not travail with trial, for more are the children of the desolate than by the children of the married wife, saith the Lord. A barren woman was often scorned in these times, and sometimes replaced by a second wife with no sons to care for her in her old age. She was particularly vulnerable. Thus, barrenness is a frequent image of loneliness and helplessness. In this verse, Jerusalem is a barren woman who will have a child like Sarah, like Rachel, like Hannah. Indeed, she will have many children. Thus, her sadness will turn to joy. Oh, I've come by to tell somebody that God is getting ready to turn your sadness into joy. I don't want you to get comfortable in sadness, but God is getting ready to turn your situation around. He's getting ready to shift your situation and turn your mourning into dancing. For I heard the psalmist say that as for me, he turned my mourning into dancing and put off my sackcloth and girded me with gladness. Somebody say, how can you be sad in this time? Because we're hearing bad news. But I got some good news, that God is still on the throne. He's still working miracles, and all power is in his hand. Somebody say, how can you have joy when we're quarantined and don't know how things are gonna go? Because my life is not predicated on what happens. Because what happens when the toys rust? What happens when the car breaks down? What happens when your bank account is empty? But I got something that trouble cannot destroy. I got a joy down on the inside that bubbles up every morning when I wake up. And I may not have everything, but I woke up this morning with a reasonable portion of my health and strength. And I got joy in my spirit and peace in my soul. Is there anybody here that will praise God that out of all the things you've been through, you still got joy? Look at somebody and tell them, neighbor, I still got joy. I still got a praise. I still got a glory to God. I still got a hallelujah. I still got a thank you, Jesus. Because when I think of the goodness of Jesus and all that he's done for me, my soul cries out, hallelujah. I gotta close. Look at what he says. Psalm 113 and 9 says, he maketh the barren woman to keep house and to be a joyful mother of children. Praise ye the Lord. In Isaiah 54:2, he says, enlarge the place of thy tent and let them stretch forth the curtains. I've come by to tell you that this is going to be a season where you're going to stretch out. Oh my God. People are looking for you to be confined. But I hear God saying that I'm using this to stretch you out. And I want the church to wake up and understand that God is causing us in this season to stretch out. We got to come creative. We got to become innovative in order to reach the people. We can't just do it testifying to each other, but we got to stretch out. Somebody has got to talk to the man on the corner. Somebody has got to tell their coworker. Somebody has got to get on social media and tell them about a man by the name of Jesus who died at Calvary and rose on the third day with all power. Oh my, oh my God, oh my God. Hey man, God is getting ready to stretch. I wish I had somebody that would just take a stretch. Yeah, because that's what's getting ready to happen in your life. No more confinement. God is getting ready to stretch you. He's getting ready to stretch your vision. He's going to stretch your money. He's going to stretch your resources. You getting ready to stretch in a time where the world is in chaos. You getting ready to stretch. There's somebody that's listening. I hear God saying, stretch your business, stretch your family, stretch your money. I hear God saying, not only stretch that, but stretch your praise, stretch your worship. Oh, I got God. Amen. I got to get ready to close. I got to get ready to close. Let me get ready to close. Amen. Understand that God, I got to skip some stuff. Y'all tune in next week. Amen. God will restore Jerusalem to unprecedented splendor. Oh my God. Are y'all hearing what I'm saying to you? God is getting ready to restore the people that after they've gone through, it sounds like to me, for I reckon that the sufferings of this present time are not worthy to be compared with the glory that shall be revealed in us. God is getting ready to take you to unprecedented splendor. He's getting ready to show you some stuff that you ain't never seen in all of your existence. I ain't got nobody here. Glory to God. I gotta go on. Amen. Amen. Let me get down. Let me get down. Amen. To the last verse. He says, no weapon that's formed against thee shall prosper, and every tongue that rise against thee in judgment thou shalt condemn. For this is the heritage of the servants of the Lord, and their righteousness is of me, saith the Lord. Using both military weapon and legal judgment metaphors, God proclaims that his people will withstand the attacks because of his protection. And if you don't praise God for nothing else, you better praise God for his protection, because there's some folks that have been trying to get to you, but they couldn't because of God's protection. Oh, I ain't got nobody here that's gonna praise God for his protection. Can I give you a couple of scriptures? Here is Job going through a hellacious period in his life, but God told the devil, you can have his stuff, but you can't touch his life. I thank God that he didn't allow the enemy to kill me while I was going through. I'm so glad that I didn't give up on myself when I found myself going through life's troubles. I want to thank God for his protection. I want to talk to somebody. Y'all remember Moses was in a basket headed down the Nile River. He should have been eaten by a coyote or maybe a fox, but because God was his protection, he got him to his his destination. And somebody here, God's going to get you to your destination because of his divine protection. I'm gonna quit. I'm gonna quit. I promise y'all, I'm giving to go to my seat. Those of you that are not on the radio, click to the live stream. We might go for another few minutes because I feel the power of God. I gotta tell you that no weapon formed. Look at somebody and tell them no weapon formed. The devil aimed, he fired, but he missed. No weapon formed. You've been fighting spiritual warfare, but no weapon formed. You've been betrayed by people, but no weapon formed. You got trials and tribulations, but no weapon formed. You suffered job loss, but no weapon formed. Discouragement tried to get you down and to abort your assignment, but no weapon formed. Depression was creeping, but no weapon formed. Anxiety was pursuing, but no weapon formed. Kids got all type of problems, but no weapon formed. A cancer diagnosis, but no weapon formed. I wish I had somebody that would stare and declare, no weapon formed shall prosper. God bless you. God bless you.
Come on, would you help me bless God? Come on. Come on, would you help me bless God? No weapon formed against you shall prosper. Come on, would you help me just bless God? Hallelujah. Glory to his name. What a word. Amen. What a word from our shepherd and from our pastor. Amen. That in these trying times, these challenging times, no weapon formed against you shall prosper. Amen. Come on, let's bless God once again. Amen. For his preached word. Amen, amen. This is a virtue altar call. Hallelujah. Those of you that are watching, amen, this is the virtue altar call. I want to give you an opportunity to draw as close as possible to the device that you're currently watching us on. I want you to touch it if you can. Then lay your hands on one another as a point of contact. We're going to pray for you. That in these trying times, our shepherd has shared with us that no weapon formed against us shall prosper. Would you lay your hands on one another as we pray, as we bombard the God of our salvation? Hata, Father, we bless you. We thank you, God, for those that have been listening, those that have been watching. Father, we believe that no weapon formed against us shall be able to prosper. And so, Father, we pray in the name of Jesus that you would bless the listening audience, that you would have your way in their lives, oh God. Father, I pray that you would save the unsaved. God, in these uncertain circumstances, there is nothing too hard for you, God. Have your way, God, in the name of Jesus. Father, as we touch one another, would you save, would you set free? Allow your name to receive glory and honor, Father. It's in the name of Jesus, Father. We call on you, God. We need your help. Father, we can't make it without you. Help us, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Father, we promise to give you glory. We promise to give you praise. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Those of you that are listening, glory to your name, Father. Thank you, God, that it won't prosper. They might form it, but it won't prosper. You're going to accomplish your purpose in our lives. And so, Father, we bless you and we thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you. God bless you. Thank you so much for tuning in to Bible Way Church. Hallelujah. Where no stranger needs to feel strange. That you can come in and worship God with us on today. On behalf of our pastor, Bishop Ronald Dimery, the First Family, and all the saints, the pastors, and those that lead this great church, God bless you in Jesus' name.